Social media drives our world today. It gives brands a medium to directly build a connection with their audience while also providing brands with a platform to run their business. This is why having an online presence is crucial for a brand's growth. So in this episode, Megha Jain, online campaign manager at Digital Freak, will guide you through the step-by-step process of creating the perfect business page on Facebook and Instagram, and teach you how to track insights and analytics so you can lay the foundation for effective organic social media marketing. Quick note, this video is a part of a series covering all aspects of digital marketing. To delve deeper into this topic, be sure to check out our other videos in this series. The link is provided below.
We are going to go to Facebook. So log into Facebook, and over here, you will see a screen like this. So you have to type facebook.com, log into your Facebook account, and the next thing you're going to do would be to create a page. Okay. So now basically how pages are created. This is how your profile would look like. This is my own profile. Okay. Now the next thing is you have to go to pages on this side. Okay. And over here you will click on create a new page like this. Just in case you feel like, you know, those are too many steps, I will give you a link as well. From here, you can directly click and create a page for your business. So the first thing that we are going to do would be to put the business name over here. So now what business will you put? It would be a fictional one. Okay. Over here, whatever you are doing would be useful in the third week of our discussion, because when we will learn the paid media marketing, there this page would be required. Okay. If you have a page, then I would ask you, are you ready to use it? I would not recommend, because people who have pages, they have some activities going on. And over here in class, suppose six people are working together. If something happens to your page, then are you ready to take that risky? That page is completely gone. So if you feel that you can take the risk, please do that. Otherwise, I would recommend create a fresh new page, and so that, you know, we have a lot of room for improvement and basically, you know, start from scratch. Okay. This is something I would recommend so that you all are on the same page. Don't use your old pages. Create a new one. And again, I repeat, page name would be fictional. You can create any name for your business. If you feel that you have your own business, you can create a page for that as well. Okay. Creating a page would never affect your profile. Page is different. It's just that page needs an owner. So the profile that creates it is the owner. Okay. So today, let's take, for example, I create something like Pearl Academy. What is this business related to? Maybe it is related to cosmetics. Okay. So over here, cosmetology school. We are a school and we provide training on that. So over here, we can write something like this. India's training school. Like this. Okay. Once you are done with this, you will click on create page. Okay. I'm not creating it because I already have too many pages. I'll tell you what will you do next. I'll take it from somewhere here. This is my dummy page that I use for teaching. Right. So over here, now the next thing you're going to do would be to set up your page. Always imagine that you are doing it for a company. So now your page would also need a cover picture and a profile picture. Profile picture is always the logo, and cover picture can be your message or maybe your product description a little bit. How are you going to create this? You will go to Canva. Okay. Canva is a tool that you are going to use for the same. Over here on Canva, you will see an option of create a design on the right top. And here you will write Facebook page. Okay. The moment you write Facebook page here, multiple options would come. Facebook cover. This is the first thing we are going to work upon. And the second thing we are going to work upon would be logo. Okay. That would be 500 pixels by 500 pixels. Logo and a cover picture. So now how this Pearl Academy is like what exactly it looks like. We can make it pink in color, right? So I'll quickly write like this, cosmetics. And we will see some, you know, pink and purplish colors over here. So now let's find something for us. Don't go with the premium one. those are paid designs. So I'll just go with something free and then I will basically play around it. So this looks good, but the colors are very dull. First thing, I'll make it white. Then over here, this leafy thing, I'll make pink. So here I click and make it pink. Academy, right? The font looks very bad, so I'll just go with Canva since it's the font like this and we'll make it bold. And this one again, Canva Sense, bold, right? How I'm making it bold from here, right? So this is something I'll make as a logo. If you feel like this complete thing needs to be a bit bigger, you can make it a bit bigger as well, like this. So this is my logo. And over here, I can create a cover picture. Again, same colors we need to use. So over here, I can take this up. This is a free picture. And over here, I'll not put anything. I'll remove the text. It looks good like that only. This looks perfect. And now I can download. PNG, download. Logo, download. And once this is run, this is where you are going to click. And you will click on upload photo. Like this. Okay. This is how you can edit your cover picture. So basically today we have to get our page ready. You know why we are doing it? Because you all are using Facebook since a very long time. But how to actually go step by step is what we are going to learn in these classes. That suppose a business hires you, a company hires you, in that case, you should know the step by step approach. Now, the next part over here is once your page is created, you basically have to put the cover picture as well and the profile picture, that would be a logo over here.
If you have made it to this point in the video, do subscribe for more such content. And click on the link below to check out our courses. We offer an array of programs from top universities in India as well as abroad. All right, now back to the lesson.
Now the next part we are going to do would be to understand how Meta algorithm actually works. So this part we have already covered, that you have to go to pages, you have to click on create a new page, you have to give a page name, category and bio. Then we have to basically give it like this. And once it is done, your page is created. Then you can finish setting up your page. At the time of page setup, they ask you for website, phone number, email ID, and location, right? You can put them all. Over here, you can add the profile picture and cover picture that we just discussed from Canva, right? Once this part is done, your page is ready. You have to click on done. This is a step that you are going to take. Now the next part you can do is you can click on manage, okay, and here you can add some more details like, you know, name, phone number, email ID, working hours, everything that can be done from here. Now the next step is we have to create our Instagram business page. That can be done only from mobile phone. So what you have to do is you have to go to your mobile phone, okay, and you have to create an Instagram account, which would be a business one. If you have a page, it's your choice if you want to use it or not. But in breakout room, if you already have a page, then other students will not learn anything from that, right? If it is a group activity. So what I would recommend is start from scratch. Okay. Many times it happens that suppose I don't know something, I make a lot of mistakes in that. Now, if you again start from there only, then you might not learn the new things that I'm teaching you right now. So what I would suggest is start from scratch. We are first going to create our page and set it up. Now, why we are setting it up is tomorrow, if you are hired by a company and suppose company says that, okay, create a page and set up everything. You should know that what would be the steps in that. Okay. So where would you create logo and cover? On Canva. So on Canva, this is a home page. You have to click on create a design on the right top. Okay. And over here, you can click on Facebook cover like this. So Facebook cover would be 1640 by 924. And the other part is Facebook profile picture. So either you can go with profile picture or logo. Both are, you know, 1:1 only. They are square. So you can go with any one of those. So today you have to decide your own company. Okay. It would be fictional. It is not a real company. Now, why are we not working on a real company? Because the moment you will put fake name Zomato on Facebook or Instagram, Facebook and Instagram both will ban your account. So this is the reason we are not going to work on any real company. We are not going to work on Zomato or Swiggy, because the moment you create something for them, they will ban your account. So you can go with something like Pearl Academy, Sunshine Traders, or Path Creations, Monica, you know, travel agency. So you have to pick your own business, and accordingly we are going to move ahead. So the first thing we are doing right now is that we are going to create a page. Okay. And we are going to create a profile picture, cover picture, and set it up. Okay. And accordingly we'll go ahead. Okay. So this much we have to do. Once this much part is done, then we'll go ahead. Now coming to the next part, how many of you know how to create an Instagram account? I feel everyone knows that, right? So will you be able to make an Instagram business account? You will. Now, should I tell you how to connect both of them, Facebook and Instagram? So what you have to do is, over here, this is my page, right? Now in this, I have to click over here and click on settings and privacy and go to settings. Okay, settings. Here you can click on linked accounts. Where did I click on first? You see this over here, right? This option. This one. Okay, you have to click on it. Like this. Click on settings and privacy and click on first option, settings. Click on linked accounts and over here, connect account. Right? Connect and here confirm, and you have to log in. The moment you log in, it would be connected. Okay, yes. So this much we have to do. Another thing is, do not switch your account to professional account. Okay, you're going to create a new business account now. So in that, they ask you whether it would be personal account or business one. So you can create personal, then you can switch to professional. Click on your profile picture at the bottom, the blank one.
Yes.
Click on the hamburger icon on top, those three lines.
Yes.
Click on settings and privacy. And over here, last option, add account. Scroll till the end. Add account. Create new account. Yeah, and you can just give a random name. Next, yeah. And click on continue, add account. Yes. Next. Skip. Okay. So everyone, this is how it is done. Account type. Click on form professionals and now switch to
professional account.
Select one. What describes your business, what it is about. This is how you create a personal account and you switch to a professional account. Let me show in the PPT part. The same thing that we have done, that you have to basically come to settings and privacy. Okay. And over here, you will go with account and you will basically switch to a professional account. Right. Now, the next thing is how to connect. Like I mentioned, you have to go to your page. Here, you will go to linked accounts on Facebook. This is my page. Over here, you will click on this, settings and privacy, settings, linked accounts, and here you can log into your Instagram account that you created just now, and they both would be connected. So whenever you post something on Instagram now, you will also have an option to post it on Facebook page. And whenever you put on Facebook, you have a cross thing, like from one to another, you will always have that option, right? On every post, you get an option to see insights like this. And these are your post-level insights. Post-level matlab post-key insights. That how many likes you got, how many people you engaged with, etc., etc.
We hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to drop this video a like and share it with your friends and colleagues. If you want to learn and explore more such topics, head on to the link below to gain access to more marketing lessons and subscribe to this channel. Until next time!